My name is Lisa Jacobs, and I'm a surgical oncologist at Johns Hopkins University and Howard County General Hospital. I take care of breast cancer or diseases of the breast and melanoma. Lumps in the breast are very common. They occur in young women as they go through puberty, and they occur in women even as they get up into their 80s. We become more concerned about lumps in the breast in women after menopause because they don't have hormonal changes that would be typically causing benign lumps. But in younger women, most of those lumps are benign. There's very common lumps called fibroadenomas that occur in young women in their late teens to early 20s. And then there are cysts and fibrocystic change that are all very benign processes that don't require any treatment. Lumps that occur in women as they get older or lumps that are hard can be suspicious and can be cancers, and those we do worry a little more about and evaluate. So lumps that occur in women who have a family history of breast cancer or a family history of benign processes are usually related to those same processes that occur in the family, but not always. So many women who come in that are young have fibroadenomas and they'll say, oh, my mother had them too. But we still want to make sure that that's what it is anytime someone has a lump and make sure that it's the process that we think it is. There are a variety of causes of breast lumps. Probably the most common in women around their 30s, 40s, and 50s is fibrocystic breast disease. Fibrocystic breast disease is a normal, well, many people say we shouldn't even call it a disease and call it change, and that's because so many women have it. And it really is just that parts of the breast form cysts and parts of the breast are a little more dense breast tissue, and that makes it feel like a lump as compared to the other areas. Those are benign. We do not generally worry about them. We just reassure people. They're also generally somewhat painful or have some discomfort associated with them, particularly if you push on them, and that generally means that it's not something that we need to worry too much about. Other causes in younger women are fibroadenomas, which are a benign process. It's just an overgrowth of the supporting tissues in the breast, not the parts that make the milk, but the parts that support the parts that make the milk. And an overgrowth of those cells can result in these lumps that occur in young women. In older women, we generally worry that there could be a cancer there if they're beyond menopause. So those we would worry a little more about. So all lumps in the breast need to be evaluated by one of your physicians. If it's a lump that has been there and it tends to get bigger and smaller, it gets smaller over time, we generally in young women will ask them to wait one menstrual cycle to see what happens to the lump. If it's someone who's had a lot of breast cysts and it feels a lot like all of their other cysts, then waiting a cycle to see if it changes or goes away is reasonable and not seeking care for it. If it's something that persists or something that feels very firm, then it is something that we should evaluate. And it persists means if it lasts more than 6 weeks or so, and or if it gets progressively larger and doesn't get larger and smaller with menstrual cycles. In women after menopause, any lump that develops should be evaluated by a physician, either your primary care physician first, or an OBGYN, or a breast specialist, someone who takes care of breast diseases. So all patients with lumps in the breast should get an ultrasound. If you're before the age of mammography, then we would just get an ultrasound. So if you're before 30, the first thing we would do would be ultrasound and not mammography. Great. The treatment of breast lumps depends on what we think it is. So if it is something that is just a simple cyst, we can either just watch it with ultrasound or just watch by physical exam, or we can aspirate it, which means we just use a small needle. It's sort of like drawing blood, but actually easier than drawing blood because the cysts are usually bigger than a vein. And so you just have to stick a needle in it and draw it out like you would draw blood. So cysts are pretty easily treated in the office. We just aspirate them if they're painful or causing symptoms. If they're not painful or not too symptomatic, we can just leave them alone and watch them. Fibroadenomas are the lumps that can occur in young women. These, if they're small, can be watched. They can be multiple, so some women have four or five of them. If they are, in general with fibroadenomas, I tell women that they get big, a third get bigger, a third get smaller, and a third stay the same size. If they're staying the same size or getting smaller, you don't have to do anything about them. The criteria for doing surgery on them are if the lump is bigger than 3 centimeters in size, if it's painful, or if it's getting larger, or if the person just doesn't like having a lump there, then we can remove them. Those are usually removed through incisions that are relatively small and placed in locations that can be a little more hidden in an effort to reduce the changes that occur in the women, in the young women's breasts. Other lumps, like lumps that might be cancers that we're worried that could be a cancer, we would do a needle biopsy first to determine what it is. And then once we have those results, then we make a decision on what to do for treatment.